everything that got me going in the actual business started right here. Music, I think, was just part of my upbringing, because my mother listened to a lot of really eclectic music. And I think the fact that I could sing was second nature. I just sang along with music, going to the Muni when I was 9 or 10 years old and seeing something and being drawn to it. The drama, I think, started with accompanying my cousin to his Bellarmine Speech League tournaments. And by the time I was in eighth grade, I want to say, we had a wonderful teacher that came to our school and started a group of us in the Bellarmine Speech League.
24 theater kids would sign up for the Catholic Action Club back in high school because Ken would write and produce and direct shows, and they wanted to be in the shows.
It was really one of those groups that used to go out and pick up trash and deliver meals and things. I turned it into a theater group. We still did outreach, because what we would do is that we would put on a play and we would get buses to bring the inner city kids in to see them, because I had been those kids.
The first time I saw him audition, people were astounded. And they kept looking at each other and said, wow, that kid is only 15.
I think I've done almost, not all certainly, but I've done so many of the character roles in the classic music theater canon. And they were roles that a lot of people don't get to play, specifically African-American male actors. And then, of course, been fortunate enough to create a few, so there's that. But when I think about high school, the reason that stays with me is because I think it set the template, that I would say, for what I would do later. It had all to do with being cast in the ensemble at the Muni. That had gone from my being in high school musicals to being a music theater major in college to working professionally. And that was sort of the gateway in.
He was just ready from the first time we met him. He had something that you don't teach. And Don Garner, my colleague, had come to us from New York, having been in professional theater all his life, and he encouraged Ken, knowing that he was ready. I mean, that he really couldn't wait at that point.
He said, look, go while you have the fire. The first job I actually got in the city was with a children's theater. Wonderful, amazing people who were the salt of the earth theater people. And when I did Guys and Dolls, I came out one night and there was this couple sort of standing off to the side, and I was signing autographs and so forth. And I looked over and they kind of waved and that. And I looked and it was Joan and Evan. So I went to them, you know, I said, and a big hug. I hadn't seen them in a couple of years, 3 years. So. And with tears in her eyes, she said to me, she goes, we didn't know if you'd remember us. I said, I'm still doing what I'm doing because of you. I was very fortunate to work at a time with people who were the masters of the art form and trade. Arthur Mitchell, Alvin Ailey lived in my building, two floors above me. Jeffrey Holder, these are all people that I lived and worked with in my youth and lifetime. And I learned things from them. And in truth, if you don't pass them on, they die. It's just that simple, you know? I mean, and not only the things that I've learned in my experiences, but the things I took from them that I applied to my experiences. If we don't write it down or pass it along, it will stop with us.
A number of years ago, the thespian conference was here in St. Louis for high schoolers. And they contacted me to contact Ken to be the keynote speaker. And I was there for a very powerful speech by him to the up-and-coming actors and actresses for the future, you know. And seeing so many of those young people react to what he said, and some were actually in tears and thanking him for reinforcing what they wanted to do and supporting what they wanted to do.
The people who believed in you when you were just trying to be heard and be seen as an artist, never forget those people, because they're really the reason why you're where you are. I want to say thank you to the Arts and Education Council for this amazing, amazing honor. Lifetime achievement. I mean, of course, I will quote Tina Turner, who says, people ask me when I'm going to slow down, and I tell them I'm just getting started. But thank you so much. It's much appreciated.